Choice depends on the freedom to choose. And if you're shackled with debt, you don't have a freedom to choose.
You ever feel like what you're seeing on this stupid little box ain't the truth?
Armed with knives, armed with chemical, biological, nuclear weapons. Fanatics, terrorists, September 11th. September 11th.
September 11th. Terrorism. Global terrorism. Terrorism.
Swine flu.
Swine flu.
Swine flu. Swine flu.
Swine flu.
Swine flu.
Swine flu.
Swine flu.
Swine flu.
Swine flu.
Swine flu.
Swine flu.
Swine flu.
Swine flu.
They're poor, they're demoralized, they're frightened, and therefore they think perhaps the safest thing to do is take orders and hope for the best.
Looks like our government is getting us pretty upset and concerned about the swine flu. This is interesting to me, not only for political reasons, but also as a physician. It makes me think back to 1976, the first year I served in the Congress. We had a vote on the swine flu. Back then, there was a panic, the panic, the panic.
The flu season is upon us. Which type will we worry about this year? And what kind of shots will we be told to take? Remember the swine flu scare of 1976? That was the year the U.S. government told us all that swine flu could turn out to be a killer that could spread across the nation. And Washington decided that every man, woman, and child in the nation should get a shot to prevent a nationwide outbreak, a pandemic, a pandemic, a pandemic.
The flu came and the flu went, and one person died, except for those individuals who died from getting the flu vaccine.
Going back to the 1989 schedule, when shots were only 10 and the MMR was on that list. I don't know what happened in 1990. There was no plague that was killing children that we had to triple the amount of vaccines.
What happened after 1989?
Why did they
It warranted 26 more vaccines.
Greed.
Are all of them absolutely necessary?
Because they want to make money.
Of course.
Pharmacist Ari Nikolitsis hadn't sold him a flu in about a year, but now he's selling out.
All right, now what do you think of the vaccination?
You know, that's the, I have more concern about the vaccine than I do about the swine flu. I've seen these people been devastated by these infections.
All right, would you give it to your kids?
I definitely would not.
This idea that government has to come to the rescue, I think it's more or less a reflection that we have too many people in government that like the idea that they have to justify their existence. So whether it's in foreign policy, scare the people to death, great fear, then you can do what you want. If it was an economic crisis, scare the people to death, and then you can socialize the economy. In medicine, scare the people to death, and then you'll say, oh, only the government can take care of us. So I think a lot of that is happening, and we're on the move to socialized medicine. So we're scaring the people and saying the only people that can save us will be the government.
Volcanic ash has left hundreds of thousands of people trapped in airports, putting the aviation industry in meltdown. But as the airspace slowly starts to reopen, the question is raised by many if the reaction to the ash cloud was indeed an overreaction. RT's Guy Nechichikian investigates.
The overall hysteria surrounding this volcano eruption is totally unwarranted. This is not the largest volcano, and often the plumes sent into the atmosphere reach even greater heights. The scale of this eruption is not that great. What we are witnessing now is an unnecessary apocalyptic reaction. There are no grounds for it.
It seems like it benefits the system if the average working person is shackled with debt.
Yes, and people in debt become hopeless, and hopeless people don't vote. See, they will say everyone should vote, but I think if the poor in Britain or the United States turned out and voted for people who represented their interests, it would be a real democratic revolution. And so they don't want it to happen. So keeping people hopeless and pessimistic. See, I think there are two ways in which people are controlled. First of all, frighten people, and secondly, demoralize them. An educated, healthy, and confident nation is harder to govern. And I think there's an element in the thinking of some people. We don't want people to be educated, healthy, and confident because they would get out of control.